today chemical bonding also. Okay, we will start chemical bonding. So please write with me. The first topic. Anomalous behavior. Of second period element. Anomalous behavior of second period element. So, first thing, first statement is, please write this with me, okay? First elements of first, comma, second, and 13th to 17th. First, second, and 13th to 17th, okay? So you have first group, second group, 13th and 17th group. First elements of first, second, 13th to 17th group differ from subsequent elements of their group. Okay, subsequent elements of their group. Wait a second, okay, some other people are joining. Then I will start the second statement. Okay, Abhinav has joined. Okay, Muhammad Umar has also joined. Let them connect to audio. Okay, Nida is joining.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. How are you?
What about you?
I'm also good. I'm also good. Thank you, alhamdulillah. So, we are starting the next topic, and this is quite the end of the third chapter, periodic properties, anomalous behavior of second period elements. Okay, now the second period elements, in this we saw that first, second, and 13th to 17th group, they differ from the subsequent element. That means lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and fluorine. Okay, so these are the elements that are the first elements of the, this is our first group, second group, 13th, 14th, 15th, 16th, and 17th. They differ from the elements that are present in the subsequent elements in the same group. So whatever is present below this, they differ from those elements. So we are going to look at what is the reason for that difference. What is the reason for that difference? So you will write the anomalous behavior is mainly due to, see, the first point is, they have very small size, right? They have very small size. For example, if I look at the second period element, they only contain two shells. And these two shells only have how many? It has SNP. Okay, SNP. But as soon as you go to the third shell, you have SP and D. And D is quite a big subshell. And that is why the increase in size is very dramatic. So first reason is the small size. Of the atom, small size of the atom, and also the ion. Whatever ion will be there, If I compare them with the subsequent element of the same group, they will be smaller. Second point is that they have small size. They have small size. But for example, lithium will have plus charge. And below that lithium, you have sodium. It will also have only plus one charge. Potassium will also have only plus one charge. As you can see that in the same group, the charge is same. In the same group, the charge is same. That means in the first group, the charge is plus one. The second group, the charge will be plus two. In boron group, the charge will be plus three. In carbon, it will be like plus four or minus four. In nitrogen, it will be minus three. In the nitrogen group, nitrogen, phosphorus, then you have arsenic. All these will be having what? The minus three charge. For similarly, in oxygen, you will have minus two charge. So all of them have same charge. But the size is small. Okay. But the size is small. That is why you will get large charge to size. Large charge to size, or we also say this as, or charge to radius ratio. So that means what? It has large charge density. It has large charge density. The charge density is larger, very large. Thirdly, they all have high electronegativity. And the fourth point is that since these have only second shell, this is only second period and second shell, only S and P are available. The non-availability of d orbitals. The non-availability of d orbitals. So these are the four points which make them behave abnormally. That means anomalous behavior. They show anomalous behavior and they differ from the subsequent elements of the same group. Please write these four reasons. Done?
Yes.
Okay. Now, what are the anomalous behavior? Okay, what are the anomalous behavior? You have seen what are the reasons now, right? The anomalous behavior. What are the anomalous behavior? See, you have the S block elements and the P block elements. Okay, in S block element, that is lithium and beryllium. Lithium and beryllium can form ionic forms. They can form covalent compounds, but the subsequent elements form ionic compound. They will form what? Ionic compound. Now, this is the for S block elements. Secondly, in P block elements, that is boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, and chlorine. These elements, what about these elements? First of all, they don't have d subshells. They don't have d subshells. Then what does it mean? If they will not have d subshells, then their valence shell will only have maximum of 8 electrons. Hence, their valence shell can have maximum of 8 electrons. They don't have d subshell. Hence, their valence electron, the valence shell can have maximum of 8 electrons. But group 3 and on, sorry, not group 3, period 3 and onwards, but period 3 and onwards, the d subshells are available. And they can form they can expand their octet. Now, next point is that due to small size, second period elements they form what? They form stable p pi multiple bonds. Okay, but the subsequent elements, that means that third period and onwards element, they don't form stable p pi multiple bonds. Period 3 and onwards, elements don't form stable p pi bonds. Stable p pi multiple bonds. So this, what is multiple bonds? And what is this p pi? We will learn about the bonds in the next chapter. That complete chapter is on bonding, that is chemical bonding and molecular structure. So we have looked on the reason for anomalous behavior and also what are the anomalous behavior in S block and P block both. Can all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is anyone still writing?
Done, sir.
Done, okay. Write the next. Okay, Muhammad Umar. Which line are you on? Which point are you on? Acha, you're done. Please write diagonal relationship. Diagonal relationship. What does it mean by diagonal relationship? The elements such as lithium, beryllium, boron. Okay, what do they do? They have some similar properties. They have some similar properties, lithium, beryllium, and boron. So below beryllium, what is there? Below beryllium, there is sodium, magnesium, boron, no? So aluminium, carbon, and silicon. So these lithium elements, they show some similar properties with magnesium. Beryllium has some similar properties with aluminium, and boron show some similar properties as of silicon. And this similar properties, these are known as diagonal relationship. Okay, the similarity in the properties, and they are diagonally, they can be represented diagonally, and hence it is known as diagonal relationship. But what is the similarity? Mean similarity that is present between the lithium and magnesium is the atomic radius. Okay, atomic radius and the ionic radius. Atomic radiuses, atomic radii, and ionic radii. Of lithium and magnesium so lithium has the atomic radii of 152 picometer, magnesium has 160 picometer. Okay, what about ionic radii? Ionic radii, lithium has 76 picometer, magnesium has 72 picometer. Okay, 72 picometer. This is if you have lithium positive. Okay, this is for lithium positive and Mg2 positive. This is for lithium positive. This is for Mg2 positive. No, you don't have to buy hard the values. You don't have to buy hard the values. I'm just showing you that the atomic radii and ionic radii of lithium and magnesium, comma, beryllium and aluminium. Don't have to buy out the values, don't worry. And boron and silicon are very similar. Are very similar. This similarity. This similarity in properties of elements present diagonally is called diagonal relationship. Known as is for what? Diagonal relationship. Is there anyone who is still writing? Is there anyone who is still writing? No?
No, sir.
Okay. No. Please write trends in chemical reactivity Okay, chemical reactivity. Now, one thing about chemical reactivity. What is reactions? Reactions are essentially movement or transfer of electrons from electron rich source towards electron poor source, electron poor species. Okay, so there are two things which are known as, one is known as electron source, the other is known as electron sink. Okay, this is known as electron rich, this is known as electron poor. Okay, so always electron will transfer from source to sink, source to sink, or electron rich to electron poor. Okay, so this will be the always you will have from electron source to electron sink. I mean, this is, we are going inside the mechanism of a reaction that we will learning, that we will be learning in the organic chemistry in detail, but as of now I'm just giving you some trailer kind of thing. Okay, what are reactions? They are essentially the movement of electrons. Okay, so if you will have, if the ease, I mean, if there is ease of movement of electron, ease of movement of electron, that means reactivity will be higher. Yes or no? If there is ease of movement of electron, then the reaction will happen fast and then the reactivity will be higher. Yes or no? Okay, that means now there are only two things that will determine, that will determine the transfer of electron. Transfer of electron ke liye kya hona chahiye? Ek aisa species jo electron de, ek aisa species jo electron le. Correct? One should donate electrons and the other should accept electron easily. One should donate easily, one should accept easily. One should donate easily, one should donate easily. That means the ionization enthalpy should be low. If ionization enthalpy is low, if ionization enthalpy is low, then what will happen? Reactivity will be higher. If delta Hi is low, that means it can easily move the electron from away from itself. If delta Hi is low, then reactivity is high. Similarly, if someone can easily take the electron, then also the reactivity will be higher. That means if magnitude of delta Heg is high, then what will happen? If the magnitude of delta Heg is high, then reactivity will also be higher. Are these two points clear with everyone?
Yes,
are
sir.
These two points clear with everyone? Now, as you know that, as we all know that, where is the delta Hi lowest? Where are the, so if you go from left to right, now you are, I mean, Muhammad Amar, are you familiar with cause and effect? These terms, cause and effect. Okay, so if you are going to push someone off the cliff, then you will see them falling down, right? You will see them falling down. So whenever you push someone off the cliff, you can see that they will fall down. But if someone is falling down, you cannot say that someone has pushed them off the cliff. So what you are doing here is you are reversing this chronology here. the sequence of events, you are reversing the sequence of events. The effective nuclear charge is less, then the electron can move easily. Then the ionization enthalpy will be low. If the effective nuclear charge is low, then only the ionization enthalpy will be low. Got it, Mohammed Umar? Now, delta HI is lower. Low at the left side of periodic table, and that is in S block elements. Delta HEG is highest at the right side of periodic table, that is in halogens. Hence we say that what? There is high chemical reactivity at two extremes and is lowest at the center. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I can say S block elements easily lose electron, gaining positive charge and forming cation. Halogens easily gain electron with negative charge and forming anions. These two terms, what we say that if somebody is losing electron, okay, loss of electron, it is known as what? Loss of electron, it is known as oxidation. Gain of electron, it is known as reduction. Okay, loss of electron is known as oxidation. Gain of electron is known as reduction. Now there are two more terms. Oxidizing agent what is oxidizing agent? The agent which facilitates the loss of electron, hai na? ट्रैवल एजेंट कौन होता है? ट्रैवल एजेंट वो होता है जो ट्रैवल को फैसिलिटेट करे. व्हाट विल बी ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट? ऑक्सीडाइजिंग एजेंट विल फैसिलिटेट द लॉस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. केमिकल स्पीसीज और एनी एजेंट, इट विल बी एटम और एलिमेंट. ओके, एटम, मॉलिक्यूल और आयन, एनीथिंग. ओके, केमिकल स्पीसी which facilitates which facilitates the loss of electron. Which facilitates loss of electron. That means oxidizing agent, if it is telling the, okay, please lose the electron. That means he wants to gain the electron. Okay. Then always oxidizing agent has power to gain electron. Okay. Has power to gain electron. That means whenever you are looking at oxidizing agent will have high electron gain enthalpy. So oxidizing agent will have high delta H Eg. Okay, so these are the 3 points. What will be reducing agent? There will be one reducing agent. The reducing agent is someone which facilitates the gain of electron. That means the reducing agent has the power to lose electron. That means the reducing agent, what will it do? Reducing agent will have low ionization enthalpy. Please write this first. Question, which of the following? Wait a second, I need to reshare this. My OneNote, sometimes it doesn't work. Which of the following? Has most oxidation. See, will have high electron gain enthalpy, and also it will have high electronegativity. Okay, high electronegativity also. Which of the following has most oxidizing power? Choose one. Which has had the highest electron gain enthalpy? Which has high electron gain enthalpy out of all these?
Fluorine.
Yeah, fluorine. You have seen that halogens, they have the highest electron gain enthalpy, right? So fluorine will be the most oxidizing. It will have the most oxidizing power. Now, right, reducing agent. Reducing agent, okay. So reducing agent will be what? Chemical species or agent. Which facilitates the gain of electron. Okay, the gain of electron. That means reducing agent has power to lose electron. Reducing agent will have low delta HI. Which of the following has most reducing power? So you have a complete chapter on redox reactions, that is reduction and oxidation. So we'll learn great detail what is reducing, what is oxidation and everything. But as of now, you just have to identify which is more, which has most oxidizing power and reducing power.
Lithium.
Okay, so obviously chlorine, neon, they will not be. They will. Okay, all of you are saying lithium. Let us see. Lithium and sodium, which has greater size? Which has higher size?
Sodium.
Sodium. So where will be the electron? From where can the electron be removed easily? Sodium, na?
Sodium.
Yeah. Now, with your information, you can say sodium. Okay, you can say sodium. But there is a slight catch here. Okay, there is a slight catch here that we will learn in redox reaction. Now, redox reaction, usse pehle aap log ko thermodynamics. In thermodynamics, we have this word which is known as hydration enthalpy. Okay, hydration enthalpy. Now, after you have learned hydration enthalpy, then you can rightly answer that lithium is the correct answer. Okay, lithium is the correct answer. But as per your knowledge as of now, you will say sodium. Okay, you will say sodium. आप लोग अपने इसमें अभी कायम रहिए. जो भी knowledge अभी तक है आप लोगों को. Slowly we will be deciphering the chemistry. So there is a catch here. Okay, please remember there is a catch here. Unless and until you learn about hydration enthalpy, you'll not be able to answer correctly. Now write oxides of oxides and their nature. Oxides and their nature. So all of you, please listen. Okay, don't write anything as of now. Please listen. Oxides and their nature. So let us start with sodium oxide. Okay. Sodium oxide. We have sodium and oxide. What is the valency of sodium? What is the valency of sodium? Nida, Omar, Reba, everyone, please tell me, Abhinav. Valency of sodium?
1.
Oh my God. What is the valency of sodium?
One.
Okay. So only Reba knows the answer. What about oxygen?
Two.
Oxygen is 2.
2. So the formula will be Na2O. Right. Now we want to check whether it is acidic or basic. Okay. We want to check whether it is acidic or basic. So what we'll do, whenever you have to check if something is acidic or basic, you just add it to water. Na2O plus H2O. Okay. Plus H2O. Then what you have to do, you have to remove each and every atom. So if you see sodium here, sodium will be in the state of Na positive, right? It will be in Na positive, right? Because it will lose one electron. It can easily lose one electron, and oxygen will gain two electrons, and hence it will be O2 negative. It will be what? O2 negative. Now, what about H2O? In H2O, you will have like this, H plus, and it will auto ionize into OH negative. Okay, H plus, and it will auto ionize into OH negative. Now, what will happen? See, first of all, you will have O2 negative. It is having what? It is electron source, right? That is negative charge here. So always electron will be flowing from negative charge to positive charge like this. I mean, there is no logic. There is no logic if it rightly goes this way towards sodium, because sodium say to ionize, okay, IIO, right? It has come from sodium. So it will go towards hydrogen like this. Now when it is going towards hydrogen. Sorry. Can you please repeat that?
Then for sodium, O-Na positive and negative. The similar way we can.
You are not audible. I mean, you're not audible. Your voice is lagging very much. Okay, so when O2 negative, it will add with hydrogen. So 2 negative and there is 1 positive, right? So the net charge will be again, it will become OH negative. OH negative, 2 negative plus positive, 1 negative and 1 positive will neutralize, 1 negative will be remaining. Now, as you can see, you have sodium positive, OH negative, sodium positive and OH negative, right? So you will make what? 2NaOH. Muhammad Umar, please think about it. Now you are saying 2 positive on hydrogen and 1 negative on oxygen. You are saying 2 positive. Think about this. Think about this at your home. H2 positive. What does this mean? As a positive charge, so kahin bhi nahi laga sakte na. It has some meaning in terms of electrons and protons and everything. So please think of what you have asked. H2 positive. Okay, think about it. How this H2 positive will be formed? As of now, we have formed Na2O, that is sodium oxide and water. It is giving me what? Sodium hydroxide. And this is what? This is acid or base? Is this acid or base? Are baba. Base na? Base. That is why sodium oxide. We have ionized the same thing. We have ionized na? Achha, you are saying like this. H plus and H plus. And O2 negative. Yeah, you can do that also. You can do that also. That will not, I mean, it is not going to affect anything. It is not going to affect anything. If you want to ionize it like that, then you can ionize it like that. One more H plus and O2 negative. Then what will happen? This O2 negative will again attack the H plus only, and then it will form one more OH negative. Okay. So essentially that is the same thing is happening. Okay. Essentially the same thing is happening. However, it auto ionizes into X plus and OH negative. You will learn in equilibrium that it ionizes into H plus and OH negative. Now it is a base. It is a base. Okay. So if you have metallic oxides, metallic oxides are basic in nature. But if you have non-metallic oxide, are acidic in nature? They are acidic in nature. Okay, they are acidic in nature. So you have many oxides. You have many oxides of the group 2 I am writing. You just write which are basic and which are acidic, and there will be some which are weakly acidic, and there will be some which are amphoteric. So please write, if you have Na2O, this is very strong, basic, very basic. After sodium, we have magnesium O, MgO. This will be basic. Then you have Al2O3, this is amphoteric. That means if you add it to acid, it will act as base. If you add it to base, it will act as acid. Aluminium, then silicon. SiO2. This is weakly acidic. After silicon, you have phosphorus. You will have P2O5, P2O3. All these will be acidic in nature. There is SO3, which is acidic. And at last, you have Cl2O7. You'll have Cl2O7. These are very strongly acidic. Very strongly acidic or very acidic. And while we are going left to right in a period, the oxides, the acidic character is increasing.
Sir, can you zoom out?
More?
A little bit more.
What, where do you want to write? Please tell me now that.
From that Na2 plus H2O.
You are forming NaOH. You can write that much reaction, Mohammed Umar. You're forming NaOH, na? Done, everyone?
Yes, sir.